Good morning and welcome to Dining Daily with Jesus through Spiritual Breakfast. This morning's message is entitled, How to Endure Temptation. You know, if Satan is not trying to cause us to become weak in our faith through trials and tribulations, he's trying to cause us to give into temptation. Well, in the Bible, we have several who teach us about temptation. We have James, Jesus himself, Joseph, Paul. All of them teach us on temptation. So today we're going to talk about what the Bible tells us about temptation so that we can learn how can we endure and overcome temptation. Now, in the book of James, chapter 1, verse 13, James says, first of all, let no man say when he is tempted that he is tempted of God. God cannot be tempted with evil, neither tempts he any man. But every man is tempted when he is drawn away of his own lust and enticed. Then, when lust hath conceived, it bringeth forth sin. And when sin is finished, it bringeth forth death. But then he says, blessed is the man that endureth temptation, for when he is tried, he shall receive the crown of life, which the Lord hath promised to them that love him. Praise God. Now we know that the devil came to steal, kill, and to destroy. But Jesus came to give us life. And we receive life, we receive abundant life, we receive peace and joy when we endure temptation. As a Christian, as a baby Christian, you're going to go through many temptations because of the flesh. We were born in sin. We have lust in our nature. The Bible tells us to love not the world, neither the things that are in the world, because all that is in the world is the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eyes, and the pride of life. And these things are not of the Father, but of the world, but they all pass away. And these are the things that Satan is going to try to tempt us with. Now, temptation is something that we should try to avoid as a Christian. We should try to avoid from allowing ourselves to even get in a position to be tempted. Paul instructs us in Ephesians 5 and 15. He says how we ought to walk, how we ought to carry ourselves as Christians. He says, see that you walk circumspectly, not as fools, but as being wise. What does circumspectly mean? It means that as you go, be aware, because your adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion, he could be around any corner waiting to devour you, waiting to throw some type of temptation into your path. So we have to be wise and we have to be looking. You have to be very wise about the things that you do, the places that you go, and the people who you associate with. Now, Jesus warns us to pray that we enter not into temptation. In Matthew chapter 26, verse 41, he said to his disciples when he was in the Garden of Gethsemane and he was praying because his time was coming when he was going to be crucified. And he asked them to watch and pray with him for 1 hour, but they fell asleep a couple of times. And Jesus said to them, he said, watch and pray that you enter not into temptation. The spirit indeed is willing, but the flesh is weak. So we're willing in our spirit to do what God has told us to do, to obey his word, but our flesh is weak. So we have to deal with this flesh. We have to give our flesh the power that it needs that it may be able to endure. And Jesus tells us how we can do that. When Jesus was tempted in the wilderness when he fasted for 40 days and 40 nights, and then he was tempted in the wilderness by Satan on three accounts, this is what Jesus said to Satan. The very first time he said, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word, that's the scriptures, that proceeds out of the mouth of God. So when you're tempted, that's what you have to do. You have to get the scripture that speaks to what you're tempted to do. Praise God. The second thing Jesus told Satan, he said, it is written, thou shalt not tempt the Lord thy God. Satan was trying to tempt Jesus. He said, well, you know, the scripture says that the angels will bear you up so you won't fall and catch your foot against a stone. He said, jump, you know, go ahead, just cast yourself off. Just jump on down because, you know, the angels are going to bear you up. Well, Jesus told Satan what the scripture said. He said, it is written, thou shalt not tempt the Lord thy God. Now, what Jesus was saying is that as a Christian, we are not supposed to just do things to tempt God. We don't want to just tempt him. And that would be what Jesus would have done if he would have just cast himself off a cliff and expected the angels to catch him. That's tempting God. We're not supposed to do things deliberately to tempt the Lord. The third thing that Jesus told Satan, he said, Satan, get thee behind me. He rebuked him. He said, get thee behind me, Satan. It is written, thou shalt worship the Lord thy God, and only him shall thou serve. So Jesus was telling him, I'm not going to worship you. He said, we as Christians, as believers, are only supposed to worship the Lord our God. You don't want to worship anything. And when we're tempted, it's always by something that Satan is trying to cause you to worship. It depends on your past. It depends on your lost life. Before you got saved, what were the areas that you were tempted in? Did you have a problem with pornography? Or maybe you had an alcohol problem? Or you had a covetous spirit where you wanted everything everybody else has? There's so many areas that we could be tempted in, but we have to know what they are. We have to know what our weaknesses are. But Jesus said he came to give us life. So what we have to do when that temptation comes knocking on our door, our flesh is tempted to sin, we have to use the word of God. We need to say, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Satan, I rebuke you in the name of Jesus. I will not worship you. I will not serve you. I will not serve marijuana. I will not serve crack. I will not serve alcohol. I will not serve fornication, and I will not serve adultery. You have to say those things. You have to rebuke the enemy in the name of Jesus. Praise God. So Jesus teaches us two things about temptation and how to deal with temptation. One, he says, watch and pray. See, there's power in prayer. That's why we need to pray every day, because you don't know what temptation you're going to be faced with in any given day. So you have to pray that God will not even allow you to enter into temptation. Praise God. The second thing he tells us is that we need to speak the word over our situation. Now, an example, to avoid fornication, don't be alone in a private, secluded place with your boyfriend or your girlfriend. That's giving place to the devil or somebody else's wife or somebody else's husband at that matter. See, we don't want to enter into temptation. You have to be watchful. You have to be wise about the things that you do. Because the Bible says, can a man put fire in his bosom and his clothes not be burned? Or can one walk upon coals on the coal fires, like on a barbecue pit? Can you walk on lit coals and your feet not be burned? No. So how you going to be, you know, lustful in your flesh, and then you're going to be alone with your girlfriend, alone with your boyfriend, expect not to commit fornication? You see, or you're married and your spouse is not satisfying you for some reason, and you have these lustful feelings, and you're running to your friend of the same sex and telling them about all your problems, and you're alone with that person in their place, you're vulnerable. That's giving place to the devil. That's putting fire in your bosom. We're not that strong. So therefore, we need to not enter into temptation. And when you find yourself in temptation, you need to use the word of God. Now also, James tells us in chapter 4, verse 7, he says, submit yourself therefore to God, resist the devil. And you know what he'll do? He'll flee. That's what Jesus did when he was in the wilderness. He resist the devil and he flee, but he came back altogether 3 times. Then he went away for a season, the Bible says. And he'll leave you for a season when you use the word of God. But he will be back. But every time he come back, you need to use the word of God to send him running. You need to draw near to God. How do we draw near to God? You got to pray. You have to get in the word. You have to just ask God to give you strength. That's all you have to do. And he will give you strength. You have to ask him to give you wisdom that you not enter into temptation. You have to also ask him to give you a willing mind to endure temptation, because sometimes we don't want to endure. We want to indulge in whatever it is, even though we're Christians. We want to make make it in our own minds, oh, it's okay, I'm only human. But no, that's not the will of God for our lives. in the first in the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 10, 13, this is one of my favorite scriptures. This is a scripture that I use in my single years, in my early years of being a Christian, when I was single, trying to endure temptation. Every time I felt tempted, I would quote this scripture. There have no temptation taken you, but such as is common to man. But God is faithful, who will not suffer you to be tempted above that you are able to bear, but also with the temptation will make a way for you to escape. Now the scripture says here, God is faithful. He's not going to allow us to be tempted to the point where we just can't bear it. I just can't help myself. We can't say that. We don't have that excuse. He says, but what he will do, he'll give you a way to escape the temptation. So there's always a way to escape temptation. We just have to take that escape way out. Joseph in the Old Testament is a perfect example. We know about Jacob's son Joseph, how his brothers were jealous of him and they threw him in a pit, and then he ended up being bought by the Egyptians, and he ended up going into Potiphar's house. And when he was in Potiphar's house, he found favor. Potiphar liked him and he worked in the house, but Potiphar's wife liked it, Joseph. Maybe it's like the example I gave a few minutes ago. Something's going on with your spouse. You know, here you got this young, handsome man in the house living with you. So when her husband was away, she wanted Joseph to sleep with her. But Joseph said, God has been too good to me. That's what we should be saying as Christians when we get tempted. God has been too good to me to do this evil in his sight. And he said, and Potiphar has been too good to me to do this evil in his sight. I cannot sin. I can't do this. So he kept telling her no. But she kept on coming back asking him. And so he fled from her. He ran from temptation. And she grabbed his garment and caught it, but he fled. Sometimes you got to run from temptation because you know you can't endure it. You can't put fire in your bosom and not be burned. You have to flee. So in James 1:1-2, James goes on to tell us, actually he tells us that earlier in the book of James. He says, my brethren, count it all joy when you fall into divers, meaning many different types of temptations, when you fall into them, knowing this, that the trying of your faith worketh patience. But let patience have her perfect work, that you might be perfect and entire and wanting nothing. What James is saying here, he's not saying that we should be perfect. Perfect means mature in Christ. When you're a baby Christian, you're not mature. You're going to trip. You're going to fall. You're going to give in to temptation. You're going to make a whole lot of mistakes. But as you continue to, if you can endure that temptation one time, if you could just say the next time you're tempted about something you've been struggling with, just tell yourself, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. And when you say that, God gives you the power to actually endure. And don't go into situations where you're going to be faced with temptation. Watch and pray. Start your day in prayer, praying, Lord God, do not let me enter into a situation where I'm going to be tempted. But if you find yourself in a situation where you're tempted, then you just need to speak the word of God. There have no temptation taken me. You should learn that scripture, 1 Corinthians 10:13. There has no temptation taken me, but such as is common to man, meaning that it's common. You're not the only one that's being tempted in this area. There's many men and women being tempted in this area. But remember, your God is a faithful God, and he said he will not suffer you to be tempted above that you are able to bear. But he will, with that temptation, also make a way for you to escape it. So all you have to do is escape it through prayer, through speaking the word of God, drawing near to God. He will draw near to you, resist the devil, and he will flee from you. And when you endure that temptation one time, the next time Satan comes back and tries to tempt you, it'll be a little bit more easier. And then the next time he comes back, it'll be even more easier. And after a while, it won't even be a temptation for you anymore, because you will have matured in that area. And you'll become entire. He says that you may be mature and entire, wanting nothing, meaning not being tempted for anything. Praise God. So once you have learned how to avoid and endure the things that tempt you, Satan won't have nothing left to tempt you with. So avoid temptation, but if you're faced with it, remember, use the word and flee from it. Praise God. This is how we can endure temptation. So let us pray about this. Pray with me. Gracious Father, we come before the throne of grace, Lord, looking unto you, the author and the finisher of our faith. We thank you, Father, for your word, Lord God, because your word is a lamp unto our feet and is a light unto our path. Lord God, we pray that you give us a hunger and a thirst to meditate in the scriptures, to hide them in our hearts, so that when the devil come to us trying to tempt us, we will know what the word of God says. For you said that man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds out of the mouth of God. Lord, teach us your word. Give us a diligent spirit to learn your word, to learn the word that speaks to our situation in the name of Jesus. Lord, I pray right now, if there be anybody under the sound of my voice that is a Christian but is struggling with temptation, that they would take charge today, knowing that they are more than a conqueror through Jesus Christ, knowing that they can do all things through Christ who strengthens them, knowing that greater is he that's in them than he that is in this world. And you said that we are more, not just conquerors, but we are more than conquerors through Jesus who loves us. So, Lord God, I pray that this word will be a blessing and that they'll continue to meditate in it, come back and listen to it again every time they find themselves struggling with temptation, because we are more than conquerors. I ask these blessings in your son Jesus' name, and we give you the glory, the honor, and the praise. And if there be any under the sound of my voice that are not Christians, let them know that if they want to be saved, all they have to do is make that commitment. You say, for if we would just confess with our mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in our hearts that God is raising from the dead for our sins, for our justification, we shall be saved. And we know, Lord God, once we accept you as Lord and Savior, that the Holy Spirit comes in to reside in us, to teach us your word, to lead us, to guide us, to empower us, to give us the strength that we need to be the child of God that you are calling us to be. And then we can receive that crown of life that you have prepared for us, who you love and who love you. In Jesus' name we pray, and we give you all glory, honor, and praise. And we thank you, Lord God, that we live by your word and not by bread alone. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and praise God. Hallelujah. Thank you for tuning in again to Dining Daily with Jesus through Spiritual Breakfast. Have a blessed day in the Lord, and remember to endure temptation. All you have to do is watch for it, pray, stay away from it, and lift up the word of God if you find yourself faced with it, and you have the victory. Have a blessed day in the Lord.